This is China's Duge Bridge, the highest bridge in the world, toppling all previous spans for height at the time of its opening in 2016. The new Beipanjiang Bridge, Duge, is the first crossing to ever surpass the 500-meter height barrier, as well as becoming the first cable-stayed bridge to ever hold the title of the world's highest bridge. Beipanjiang Bridge in southern China offers an otherworldly experience as you drive almost 2,000 feet above the water below. The bridge offers breathtaking and somewhat terrifying views of the rocky Beipanjiang Valley and turbulent Beipan River. The construction cost was huge, but the bridge broke records all over the world for its height and innovation, cementing China's status as the country with the highest number of tall bridges. Built above the Beipanjiang Valley in China's Guizhou province, the Beipanjiang Bridge, also known as the Duge Bridge, sits an impressive 565 meters, or 1,854 feet, above the Beipan River, which is equivalent to a 200-story skyscraper. Beipanjiang Bridge is a four-lane, cable-stayed bridge on the border between the provinces of Guizhou and Yunnan, an area known for being difficult to navigate and travel. The bridge spans 1,341 meters, or 4,399 feet, across the valley, giving travelers a safe and breathtaking way to travel within the region. But this convenience came with a massive price tag of 1.023 billion yuan, or around 147 million US dollars. When the bridge was completed in 2016, it became the highest in the entire world thanks to the height its deck stood above the valley below, officially making it into the Guinness World Records in 2018. But its record-breaking height shouldn't be confused with the other tallest bridge in the world, the Millau Viaduct in France, which cost $424 million. The viaduct is known for its tall structure, but it doesn't have the height under its deck that China's bridge does. It has a structural height of 336.4 meters or 1,104 feet. In comparison, the Beipanjiang Bridge's tallest tower is just 269 meters or 883 feet high, making it the 10th tallest bridge tower in the world. But it still broke the record for the highest deck compared to the ground below it. In addition to being the highest bridge in the world, the Beipanjiang Bridge also uses the second longest ever span of steel truss cable. But how did this bridge manage to break so many records and become an iconic symbol of innovative engineering all around the world? To understand that, we'll have to take a look at how it was made. It took 3 years of construction to finish the bridge by 2016, but discussions and design officially began back in 2011. The gorge the bridge crosses is so deep that the structure had to be able to withstand the strong wind field created by the valley below. The engineers decided to go with tough steel truss cable to provide the flexibility and strength needed to keep the bridge standing. Its location definitely played a part in how tall the bridge ended up being. The original design estimated a height that was a couple of hundred feet lower, but the designers had to keep moving the bridge higher and higher to avoid the cracks and caves present in the mountains on either side of the valley. This trial and error process made the bridge so iconically high, though it also increased the budget by an estimated $20 to $40 million. However, running into these problems wound up being completely worth it in the end. We mentioned that the bridge connected areas not even accessible by vehicles, so it's not hard to imagine just how much the bridge's creation changed the travel time and habits of those in the Guizhou province of southern China, which is a land of mountains, high plateaus, rivers, and canyons. The bridge is part of the G65 Hangzhou Railway Expressway between Kujing and Lupanshui. The entire four-lane divided highway that the bridge is part of stretches an incredible 2,935 kilometers, or 1,825 miles, from the city of Hangzhou near Shanghai to the border of Burma near Tibet. Upon completion, the bridge decreased. Travel time from one side to the other from about 3 hours to just 5 minutes. It also shortened the overall travel time between Xianwei City, Yunnan, and Xuching County, Guizhou from around 5 hours to just an hour. It's a structure that brings together communities, allows visitors to explore other regions, and increases the amount of tourists attracted to the area. This, in turn, increases the economy of some of these smaller communities that took a lot longer to access without the bridge's help. The bridge's creation even improved integration between regions, since people have more freedom to move where they'd like without travel being a complicating factor. And of course, the bridge is also a proud symbol of China's growing financial strength, engineering abilities, and overall position in the world. We briefly mentioned that China has a reputation for building tall bridges, but it's hard to believe just how far ahead they are in this respect than the rest of the world. China has both the second and third highest bridges in the world as well. They are the Saidu River Bridge at 496 meters or 1,627 feet high, and the Pulley Bridge at 485 meters or 1,591 feet. The Beipanjiang Bridge is the tallest in China since the Saidu River Bridge, which it beat in both height and cost. The Saidu Bridge,